Hello friends, most welcome to English Advantage online classes. Friends, in this video we will discuss SSC CGL 2017 Tier 1 paper or exam. This exam was conducted on 6th of August 2017 in the morning shift. So let us get started with this video class. This is question number 1 and this question belongs to spotting error part. Now question reads, Chilka is the largest brackish water lagoon in Asia. Okay, so Chilka is the name of the lake and this is the largest brackish water lagoon. This is a salty water lagoon in Asia. So this is preceded, largest is preceded by the. So this is correct. Brackish is correct here. Lagoon is also correct and in Asia. So this sentence is correct and answer is D, that is no error. Let us see the question number 2. The climb upside the mountain was not easy. This is a quite basic question. The climb upside the mountain was not easy. Now we are talking about, since adjective easy is being used here and this adjective is used for this noun. So climb is being used here as a noun, not as a verb. So that is why you cannot use upside with the climb, because this is a superfluous word or extra word, you can say. In place of this upside, you can say the climb of the mountains was not easy. The climb of the mountain was not easy. So here your answer is A. Now if you want to join the target batch initiated by English Advantage Education, you can definitely join it before 25th of July. And in this target batch, you can get the video classes of complete English syllabus and complete GK syllabus. So regarding joining the target batch, you can give me a call on this number 9893719933, or you can visit the description box below the video. In the description box, you can find the link to join the target batch. Now this is question number 3. Rituals play into the understanding of a society. Play into means they help to support. Okay, so rituals play into what? Rituals play into understanding. Now understanding of what? What kind? Now here you need adjective. And there are two words that are adjective in this in these options. Tactfully will be wrong because tactfully is an adverb. Tacitly will also be wrong because this is an example of adverb. Now taciturn is someone who doesn't speak much. Okay, so taciturn will not be fitted here. Now the correct answer is tacit. Now tacit means what? Tacit means implied. Rituals play into the tacit understanding of a society. This is quite right. Let us see the question number 4. Repetitions bred a sense of with the characters. When we say repetitions bred a sense of, now this common sense say that sense of what? So here you need a noun. Okay. And out of these 4 options, which word is the noun? Only familiarity is the noun. Okay. Familiarly is adverb, familiar is adjective, and familiarize is verb. So familiarity will be the right choice here. Repetitions bred a sense of familiarity with the characters. Let us see the question number 5. Similar word, incensed. What is incensed? If you are incensed, you are very angry and you are infuriated, you can say. So the equivalent word of incensed is exasperated, or you can say angry. Okay, so here your correct answer is exasperated. Ecstatic means extremely happy. Elated means extremely happy, and blithe means happy and carefree. Okay, so here your answer is exasperated. Let us see the next word. Similar word, transcend. Transcend means to go beyond, to rise above the something, or you can say overshadow somebody or something. And equivalent of overshadow is eclipse. So here your answer is eclipse. Abort means to be unsuccessful. Blunder means mistake. And fizzle means end of something with the hissing sound. So here your correct answer is transcend. Let us see the next opposite word, incapacitate. Incapacitate means what? Incapacitate means to decrease the capacity of someone. Okay. And to facilitate means to aid or help someone. So here your answer is facilitate. Cripple means cause someone to become unable to walk or move properly, or you can say cripple means to disable someone. Okay. Immobilize means to stop someone, and mime means to disfigure something, to distort something, and the opposite of mime is heal. Let us see the question number 8, opposite word sentience. Sentience means to be able to feel something, okay, to accept or to take the feelings of something. So the opposite of sentience is disregard. Let us see the next question, and this question belongs to idiom and phrase part, rat race. What is rat race? Rat race is a way of life in which people are caught up, they are stuck in a fiercely competitive struggle for wealth and power. Okay, without worrying about their health or without worrying about the peacefulness of mind, they are running for the money. So this kind of running or this kind of struggle is called rat race. So here your answer is C. Spin one's wheel. What does this idiom mean? Spin one's wheel. When you spin your wheel, you do lot of effort. You put in lot of effort in something, but you achieve nothing. Okay, so that process is known as spin one's wheel, or you can say expel much effort for little or no gain. A small makeshift stage with a red curtain for a backdrop. You have to improve this sentence. And you have to improve this bracketed part. Now the sentence has been written in passive voice, so that is why this was will be followed by third form of the verb. So here your answer is was constructed. Take out your binoculars and see the Andromeda galaxy. Since we are using the first form here, and this first form is combined with this and, so here also you have to use the first form. So here your answer is first. Let us see the next question. Take away or alter the natural quality of something. This is one word substitution, and this is called denature. Okay, denature is the right answer. Unadulterated means fresh, authentic means genuine, and limpid means transparent and clear. This is used for water. So here your correct answer is denature. Decay of organic matter produced a fetid smell. Fetid smell means unpleasant smell, and if something is decayed, it's called putrefy. Okay, putrefy is the correct answer here. So these are the 15 questions, most expected questions, and these questions were asked on 6th of August 2017. So I'll keep uploading such kind of video on this channel, on English Advantage YouTube channel. So that's it for now, and I'll see you in the next video class. Thank you.